better now that I get to interview you. I've been a big fan of yours in the WWE from start to finish. I'm more of a fan of the high flyers, the death defiers. You guys put your bodies on the line in multiple ways. One in particular is the Money in the Bank ladder match. One of my favorite moments, because as before the match, I was saying, there's nothing anybody can do that I haven't seen at this point of all my years of watching wrestling. And you made sure that you went out there and you showed people things that they've never seen. For example, the moonsault to the outside with the ladder. Where did this idea come from, and where did you, you know, muster the guts to pull it off?
Like this blank canvas where you can go outside the box a lot and do things that you can't do in a regular wrestling match. So when you evolve from one to one opponent, tag team match, or a line or a chair, or those things, the possibilities are limited. And all you gotta do is just think about something else. Pretty much do whatever you want. Prior to that match you're talking about WrestleMania in New Orleans, I'd done a moonsault on top of Paul's ladies' face while I'm holding a chair, and I realized, yeah, that's the part. I could probably do it with a ladder. That was one of those ones that I didn't even try. I just like felt the ladder, stood up for like one time, like before the match, and I was like, alright, I'm pretty sure I can do this, let's just see what happens.
I like that confidence, you gotta have it. If you have a second of doubt, it's gonna go alright. So how much creative freedom do you get in those kind of matches to say, I'm gonna try this, or I'm gonna try that, or is there you know, the proverbial Nazi behind the scene that's like, no, John, you can't do this.
I'm assuming you're talking about creative. You know what? You have quite a bit of creative. What you really need to do is make sure that you have an idea that you can do. A lot of people have ideas that they can't do. They think they can do it with that one. And to me, this is going to hurt somebody, especially somebody else. Because then no one's going to want to work with you. If you have something that's innovative, not going to hurt you, you can do, not going to hurt somebody else.
That's wonderful to hear, and I look forward to all the creative, crazy shit that you come up with in the future. But before the interview, you mentioned that you're working on a workout video.
Okay, yeah, you're going to talk about all this stuff.
Shameless self-promotion. Take one.
I do my fitness. It's an extreme functional workout program that will get you in the shape of your life. That's from Slabby. I just made that up on the fly.
This is how he does.
Fabby's not a word that I would think that anyone really wants to be. It'll get you into the best shape in your life. I'll just leave it there.
John Morrison is a superstar, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me. He can say whatever he wants, and it will turn to gold.
In that case, I'm going to just start talking really big. I'm going to leave it to you. Just finish my thoughts and then you know how sometimes when you've got a cake, but it's on a slanty surface, and somebody hits the table and it shakes and starts to slide down? Out of Your Mind Fitness is going to show you how to make that slanty surface that you're resting your cake on to a flat table.
What John Hennigan is trying to say is that for the purchase of the workout DVD, he will put you into the greatest shape of your life, and you will look absolutely amazing. Not quite on the level of John Hennigan himself. That is a level of devotion that you need to take amongst yourself.
That was pretty good. I was going for more like, without a strong foundation, you can't really build anything. But that was a second
promotion. That would have been my second promotion. Is there anything else, any other local promotions? Are you currently not signed with the WWE? Is there anything else that you're working on, pro wrestling-wise, that you'd like to promote this time?
I did a great show with Resistance Pro, their local promotion. Team to Union Hall, that was a lot of fun 2 weeks ago. That was great. I'm looking forward to doing something else with Resistance Pro at some point in the future. I've been doing a lot of fun, things, having a lot of good time to get on my own schedule. And, aside from that, follow me on Twitter, at Phil Morrison. Check out my YouTube channel, Palace of Wisdom. And that's it, dude. That's all the John Morrison that probably anyone will know.
Minus gold. All right, ladies and gentlemen, decodemag.com, John Hennigan, signing out. Thanks a lot, man.